Okay, so now here is the next observation. We've already concluded that we can bring one block of C into registers and then compute by streaming columns of a block of A and rows of a block of B through the registers, thereby allowing more of the register to be used for matrix C. And in later exercises, you're going to see that there's going to be a benefit from that. Now, the overhead in terms of the time spent moving data between registers and memory, according to our model, is then given by this. Now, recall that we can place that microtile or the block of C in the registers and then do many computations with blocks, performing that block times that block plus this block times that block plus this block times that block plus this block times that block. But if you order the loops in that way, then you can actually simply say, oh, we don't need to partition matrices A and B into the smaller blocks. It suffices to partition matrix A into row panels, matrix B into column panels, and to then perform a matrix-matrix multiply with those entire panels all at once, orchestrating those as a sequence of rank one updates. Now, where we now have arrived is that this right here is the critical computation that then is performed when we try to utilize the registers of a core. This particular computation we're going to call the microkernel. It's the computation performed by the microkernel, and that is what we're going to optimize next. This right here is referred to as a microtile. It's the part of matrix C that we park in registers. This here is a micropanel of A, and this is a micropanel of B. And notice that the micropanels of A and B are streamed through the registers as computation happens in order to do the rank one updates.